So the lady I could tell the lady, please come to church.
She could come late.
When she started saying, Pastor, I think I need to give time too much to my child. I think I need to give time too much to my husband. I said, thank you so much. But I think you need to give even more time to the God that you serve. No one must remind you. No one must remind you about the kingdom of heaven. No one must remind you about the time of the kingdom. We must remind our soul. We have meetings on Sunday that is dangerous. We have parties on Sunday that is dangerous. We have interruption on Sunday that is dangerous. It is one day. 6 days you are free to do anything. On a Sunday, on the day of the Lord, let me tell you, we can separate. I had a church in Chalawajara. There is a time people came, and I believe the Musumba is watching me right now. We were meeting with him there, and there is a time people came. I didn't deliver a tree. Today I wanted to stop the service by me, by 11. Because I wanted to come here, preach on the chairs, anoint the chairs, and as I see you coming, I say let us share the grace.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
My mother called me in the morning. I was standing around there.
But then you
and he said, at this time you are picking the call. We are from the first service. I said, a Catholic man is coming, is
waking
up knowing there is a service. What about the man who understood the meaning of the day of Pentecost? Who doesn't know the day of the service? You are not supposed to be called. Are you coming to church?
You know?
It's like calling. Are you going to heaven?
As
a leader of this big ministry, bless your name. The service is done. If they delay, 12:30. Andrew, move with me there. The service begins at 6:00. The other leaders will not be there. When I'm there is when the service delays.
Praise
the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God work on me. God work on me. You don't want to serve him. There are three decisions that you must take in life. One, salvation. Two, service. Let others cannot serve. Three, thanking him. Those three decisions is an important decision. You can't forget with one. Somebody is going to come walking, and he hears worshiping here. And he comes and sits for 2 minutes, and see the chairs are empty. A visitor must not welcome a judgment. Impossible. How are we going to win soul when we are lazy? I can count how many days I've eaten on Sunday before the service in this year. I can count them. If too much, Andrew moved with me everywhere. By
7
I have the chai on my table. But I don't take it. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Why? Food is the second part in my life. Other thing is the second part in my life. The first thing is Christ. I can eat and get satisfied. But when something is rotting inside me, you have struggled in this kingdom. You have done a lot of things. You have changed many pastors. You have moved to many people. There is a secret. There is a reason why your life is not changing. We have loved the world more than the way we love God. This cross is useless to me if I have God. I can lose everyone, but if I lose God, I've lost everything. I can lose everyone, but I have God, I have everything.
Amen. Amen.
Where you sit alone.
What you walk to
and say, Lord,
no gamba katonda.
What time should I give you? I can tell you.
So
when you are praying, you pray as if you are praying for food. Father, I bless your name. You are great God. Okay. Thank you. Give me.
Ugambe katonda.
What to see a man here who will come here in the morning?
Grab
a microphone and say, I don't have anything to tell God. I just want to tell him, God, I thank you. Because Monday to Monday, people are dying. But I am alive. But now, after some minutes, you will see them moving
on.
See them looking at their watch. Even those who came late, when he come here, I want to be anointed first. Which anointing is that when you came late?
Anointed first.
So I told the lady, ever give excuse that I was preparing the
child.
So the lady left time, reached time. And she said, let me leave worship. The lady said, let me leave worship. So that I can take care of my marriage. Ah, I said, you're leaving worship to take care of
your
marriage. I want to declare to you that God has left you. Do you know what happened? What? Within 2 weeks, the child got sick. She was moving, running, fell down, got sick. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know when was the day? It was a Sunday. After the washing, preparing the child, it was not around
then.
Because now she started moving at her own time. Within 3 hours, the child died. When we are for the burial, the demon, the spirit came to the woman and told the woman, I have taken the person that used to interrupt you.
Now,
hallelujah. From 2016, she got another child 2 months ago.
2016.
If God wants to use you, He will do everything to use you. He will remove everyone that interrupts your life. So save the life of your child. Save the life of your job. All of us are working. All of us have business. But we have understood what is written in Matthew chapter 6. Verse 33. Read it for me. I'm so glad
that Jesus set me free.
I'm so glad that Jesus set me free. He set me free. I'm so glad today that Jesus
set me free.
Now let me sing. Hallelujah. My Jesus
set me free.
Read for us, Mayuta.
Instead, be concerned above everything else with the kingdom of God and with what? And with what He requires of you, and will provide you with all these other things.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. There is a version that I need so much. Try looking for a version. It is a bit so direct. Thank you so much for that. Yes.
But seek first his kingdom.
I love that. Listen, but seek first, not second. A business cannot stand unless you seek first the kingdom. We are so sorry. Yesterday, the vehicle of our engineer got an accident. He was with me on Wednesday. And I told him that your car is going to get accident. One of the cars called pickup. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said the pickup is going to get accident. Check the power. If the power is off, we can use our generator. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when that happened,
He was like, but you told me. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
He said, you told me. Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen. Seek first the kingdom. The reason why everything is failing in your life, you started with other things. Now you remembered God. Let me tell you this. And I tell you people, you are going to wake up in the morning and say, let me go and deal with the business before God. And it's a day for the Lord. You will see a lot that you have never seen. You will see a lot that you have never seen. The Bible says, seek first the kingdom. You need a wife, the kingdom first. You need marriage, kingdom first. You want to work somewhere, kingdom first. You need a job, kingdom first. Some of you are suffering today because you first started by seeking your own desire. And God said, okay, you seek your desire. How will I deal with you? Thank you so much. Power is back.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to preach to somebody who is outside there.
They must
understand that they should pass the kingdom. Listen to me, ladies and gentlemen. You have seeked a lot of things before. And now seek the kingdom of the Lord. There is a secret in the kingdom. There is a blessing in the kingdom. Born again, I expected to be advanced in knowledge. You wake up and begin looking at someone new things. And that is the reason you are still in one position. You see somebody coming and say, okay, it's now time for service. Are you supposed to be reminded? Pastor, I'm not going to make it.
No,
God, I'm not going to make it. Because I'm going to celebrate the world. I don't have a guide. If I tell you how many times I walked 14 kilometers, the person you see standing today here paid for what I get today. I pay for it. There is a price, and the price is painful. You are saying, God, what should I sacrifice? I don't have money. The first sacrifice in this kingdom is commitment.
Amen.
Amen.
Not money.
Amen.
The biggest opening in this kingdom is time.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? Amen. You can pay your time.
Amen.
But that time is useless. You can be serving everyone food here. It is useless when you don't commit yourself in doing this. How many people here have altars in their houses? Some of you have altars in your houses. Put up your hand.
You have
altars in your houses. You have altars in your houses. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm talking about the altar of the Lord.
Amen.
I know there are altars. There are people with bars in their house. Seek first the kingdom. And all other things will work. So meaning, why it has not worked? Jesus cannot be a second. Let me tell you. I mean, I can lose a woman. I can lose a woman. I can lose a mother. I can lose a father. Any person that hinders me from serving God, you better go. I remain with the Lord. Because you will leave me the world, and I will go to the kingdom of the Lord. Nothing is too big for me.
There's
a lady one day told me, I would have loved you. But that bulokole in you. I said, thank you so much for coming. Thank you so much for opening the gate for other people. But when you're walking out of me, don't stand at the gate because other people must enter. You're walking out of my life. Go. Don't stand at the gate. Because others are entering. Help me. Don't stand at the gate. The secret of the kingdom. Every day you sleep. You dream bad. And there you change the church. There is a secret.
One way, chama. We have a party beginning at 2. You need to meet me. By midday you are there. Preparing the gomas. You prepare the gomas. You don't prepare your spirit. No problem. You will remain a beggar in the right way. In the beautiful gate, you will be a beggar.
Do
you understand what I'm saying? They will not tell you this because they will just tell you chito chituare. Yeah, will tell you.
Mbabi no, kumanga baje kugamba chito chituare ne yeye ajabi tugamba.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's pray for the word.
Akusabile chigambo.
Father, you have spoken. I thank you for this word. Continue blessing us. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Amen. I greet all of you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And all our visitors, that's not our manners. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But as the overseer of this ministry, I tell you, I will not sit down and see people getting out of the way. No. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
At midday, you are asking whether the service is there.
Sawa mukago buza waliyo kusaba.
And you want to meet me in my at office. Pastor, I
can
come to your office.
So
come to the church.
Yangu
come to the church. That's my workplace. When I come to the
church,
you are lucky. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Because I know there are people here. Jesus set me free. I'm so glad that Jesus set me free. I'm so glad that Jesus set me free. Singing glory, hallelujah. My Jesus set me free. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Get ready for us. 8:22.
One day Jesus said to his disciples, let us go over to the other side of the lake. So they got into a boat and set out. As they sailed, he fell asleep. A squall came down on the lake so that the boat was being swamped and they were in great danger. The disciples went and woke him, saying, Master, Master, we are going down. We are going to drown. He got up and rebuked the wind and the raging waters.
Stop there. You can take your seat a little bit. Today I want to change your prayer today. Your prayer must be, oh Lord, arise and take me to the other side. Some of you are in the other side of the river. And you are trying moving. But in the middle of the journey, something happened. And he went back. The first thing here was a desire to move. When he desired to move, you move. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Listen to this. There are two factors responsible for transformation. One, willingness to learn. And two, willingness to change. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, we see here Jesus. And we see him telling people, let us go to the other side. We see him telling you right here that my sister, let us go to the other side. But you are still at home. You are still in the world. He's saying, let us go to the other side. I am using the boat. A church is the boat for crossing. Your spiritual leader is that boat for crossing. Hallelujah. Now listen to this. When Jesus said, let us go to the other side, they
got
and they started the movement. Everyone was happy. When you come to the kingdom, I see the joy. I see everything. When they're saying, let us go, you're saying, then let us go. Now you are in the church already. The storm has started. And the person who brought you, the Jesus who told you to enter the church, is in the boat.
Jarangumu kanise. Leo mtu ya kuleta ali muli ato muno.
I pray God give you the grace to pray, to interpret me today, because I am too much power packed in the name of Jesus. Let me tell you, there are times when challenges will prove to you that it's not maybe that church that will take you somewhere. There are times where challenges will prove to you that you just need to get going more. There are times when challenges will rise above your strength. There are times when challenges will rise above your ministry. Time will come where challenges will make you look like a fool in the kingdom of the Lord. You have been in Muslim for many years. You have been in Catholic for many years. You have been in salvation for many years. And challenges will come and tell you that you are just 2 days. And some people will say, I believe these disciples will even say, Jesus, let's go back to
heaven.
Hallelujah. Amen. I know you have sent of God everywhere. In fact, you're supposed to see him more till when you get the right place. Because when you sit and say, I'm not going to the church, I'm not going to see God again, you are settling a problem. The devil will say, aha, that is how we want them to be. But the time, every time the challenges arise up, don't settle down. Because the effort you're going to use to go back is the same effort that will help you going forward. Don't settle in problem. There are wrong people, we agree.
Sorry?
There are wrong people, we agree. That is true.
Chitufu.
But move till when you get the right one. Because among the wrong one, there is the right one. I see you have lost hope. Some of you are here. Today you are going to drink so much. But outside, you are here. You see, you are here. Outside, you are wearing another coat. Not you. Hallelujah. And you're wearing another cloth out. Inside, there's something different. Let me tell you, God cannot be mixed with evil. You either remain where you are than fooling God. It cannot be mocked, it cannot be fooled. Look at what you did on Friday. How many bottles of beer you took on Friday? And on Sunday, say God, take me to the other side. Taking who?
Atwala.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I know you have a very funny scripture inside you. That Jesus said, come as you are.
Yes, you are but
thank you so much. After coming, what next? Take off your shoes. Because where you are is the holy place. I will empower you. And you will move.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So Jesus said,
yes, we are
let us get to the other side. Let me tell you, time comes where challenge will come to your life. And you will say, apostles prophesied all them who prophesied. I don't know how many times of oil I've received. I think I'm only remaining with receiving cooking oil. But I've received the paraffin, I've received the water, I've received everything. I am even baptized. But why? Why am I not selling this land? Why am I not growing? Apostles have come. Now we have prepared food for us. He kept dressing all type of detail. He was in the court, he was in the shot, but why? And God said, you know what? You are just seeing water. There is a wind. Hallelujah. There is a wind. Listen to this scripture so much. In every storm, those who are writing, go with me now. In every storm, there are two things. And even in the lake, we saw two things. Thank you so much, Ellen from Zambia, you're following us. We love you so much. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Listen. In every storm, there are two things. There is a wind. And there is water. Are you hearing me? For a rain to be called a stormy rain or heavy rain, there must be wind. Listen. In this boat, there was a storm. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And this storm, there were two things. There was water. And there was wind. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now follow me. Wind was not seen. Indeed, when there is a storm, you don't see wind. But you see water bubbling. Praise the Lord.
Amen.